I didn't record my session, but it's fine. I can recon it now. Okay. So let's be honest, okay? So let's check on our current state, which is something that you already go through just now. So these were actually like what are the key highlights from AEPP and AEPP and APIP, right? So basically, these are the key things that has actually changes in the internal policy. And this is something that we actually need to make sure that we are fulfilling on that. And then from there, we also have GV principle as well, which means that if we run GV, these are the principles that we must fulfill. Like, for example, Isaac cannot be the OP. We must sign the contract before open the opportunity. The contract should be reviewed by the lawyer. And also the date of realization must be the real one, which means that we should always change our date to make sure that it reflects on the actual realization date. And also OP must be the one who charged by us in 2023, EP can only charge by 30%. So all these things are the principle that we should fulfill when we run the product. And these are the conditions that we should have in order for us to run IGV, right? So before we can actually implement whatever GV principle, we need to make sure that we fulfill this condition, which means that we should have safety in place. We also fulfill our program minimums, which is all the things that is mentioned above, actually. And then also having a clear risk management plan. If there is EP happening, they are stuck. What are the communication plan? What are the accommodation plan? What are the lockdown plan? What are the like agreement with the global host? And all these things are something that we need to do. And you're already aware on it because these are the information that has been downscaled from ESGI or from AI consistently every month. And also reflect on the global ICOM channel as well. So let's check on the progress, right? As Asia Pacific, what are the things that we fulfill the most and what are the things that we actually need improvement? So as you can see is that all EP must have EPM on expat, but I got 150 without LC assignment. Then I don't know how to. Okay. Yes, you need to ask them to do it. Okay, so for OGV conditions, you can see that is that as regionally, we are good in OGV for profit, at least this is 61%. However, the concerning thing is that not all the NDD actually adapt to the SOP and also having a clear action, a communication plan and also action plan. What does it mean? I think when I was actually reading through the responses survey that you gave, a lot of you were saying things like, because you are working on EWA, because you are not going to have realization soon, that's why you are not prioritized this soon. So what is it is that like, I will tell you more later on with the conversation later on, but I think this is something that to be aware is that right now we are not ready or we are not able to communicate to our customer about the safety measure. And remember that on yesterday external contact session, right? Remember that the safety is actually the brand that the customer is seeking for. And also I read article before that customer actually require agency or company to actually provide them more information. In fact, there's actually customer thing that we should over communicate or we should communicate more rather than communicate less. So that's what it means in Isaac, right? Even though we are not doing realization right now, however, there is no proper communication are being done to our customer. They are actually in the funnel. And if you look into the fulfillment, I want to take the space to congrats Isaac in Indonesia. You probably get congratulated every month. So maybe nothing new for you. You're like, yeah, like what's so special. And then we also have newcomer like Sri Lanka and also Myanmar. There's actually joining us as well. So welcome on board. And then, but beside that, if you look into like the exchange, like how many entity are already start doing operation without a proper communication in place, you will notice like, for example, MOC, there's one approval, there's gonna realize in this winter peak as well. So there's no communication, there's no any fulfillment being done. So I do not know how the customer gonna get informed. And also same with Hong Kong, although it's 83%, but it's still lacking off. And India is one of the big concern, even though they only have like two realization in this peak. However, like there's no, I'm not able to track like or ensure that all the customer in India can be actually be assured that there is a proper safety for them because I don't see 100% fulfillment. And then you can see that follow-up is like for Nepal, Pakistan, and then also Thailand and also Vietnam are the entity that you already have result. However, you do not have fulfillment. So it means what? It means that you are approaching your customer without a clear communication plan. And you're expecting that they kind of can go exchange. And for me personally, if I'm a customer, I would not go for Isaac because it's really not safe, to be honest with you. Especially looking at Isaac in Malaysia, it has 0%. Like if I'm a customer, I'll be like, fuck Isaac in Malaysia, I'm not gonna go. Okay. But I'm Malaysian, so it's okay. Don't have to get offended, Lina. It's fine. Okay, so I was the MCP before. Okay, so for IGV conditions, what you can look on it is that like it's the same SOP and IPS. SOP has seems to be like one of our main enemy. It seems like it was used to be our favorite. Now it has actually least fulfilled. And also IPS as well. I understand IPS, why is it not adapted and it was deprioritized? It's mostly because people are thinking that, okay, because I'm not having realization soon, that's why I would deprioritize it. And also same with the lockdown and also OP taker cancellation plan. These are the ones that is actually like seriously far behind from the progress. However, if you look at the rest, it's not like we are all on track with the rest of the thing as well. There are actually a lot of criteria that are actually not fulfilled in AP region. So if you look at it, as usual, Azan Indonesia did a great job. To be honest, you are my favorite GV babies. I just want to let you know, although you are not baby, but like you're adulting, okay? But you are like transforming into a beautiful butterfly to make sure that your customer has the best of the GV. And also Myanmar, Nepal, and Sri Lanka. We actually have newcomers as well. So welcome Nepal and Sri Lanka to the group. So there's actually like a quite good progress that we are making. However, like I think the concerning thing are like for the rest of the entity that actually has approved result, but then there are still not 100% things done yet. So I know that like you will tell me that, show me that you have different reasons. So later on, we have a space where you can tell me what's the reason why you cannot fulfill 100%. But before we start before we go proceed, I will address Isaac in Malaysia. 0%, one approval. Like as your predecessor, I have one word for you: disappointment. But other than taking it personally, joke aside, I think that it's really important to make sure that like for the entity that already have result, especially like India, Cambodia, Taiwan, Thailand, and Vietnam, also making sure that you are fulfilling it. So even though like your entity wasn't being mentioned, I don't dare to offend you. I dare to offend Malaysia because that's where I'm from. But to be honest, like you need to make sure that you are taking care of the safety of your customer. So, if you look at the opens as well, we have crazy amount of opens, especially as in India, before this, Nepal and Sri Lanka had a huge amount of open without fulfilling the criteria. So it means that we are still having the kind of open. There wasn't set a proper expectation to the customer and also to the EP about the kind of opportunity that we have. So like, I think this is something that's really important to be aware that what are the risks that we are bringing. In the end of the day is that as regional office, it's very easy for me to tell you that be careful not to make mistakes, take care of the risk. But it's not me, they are the one who's going to handle the risk. You are the one who's going to handle the risk. And when we see the risk behind the way on how you're running the operation, we can't help but just to remind you. Because in the end of the day, as regional office, I cannot go to your entity and say, you know what, I'm going to help you to do GV because nah, this is how you do it. Like, that's not how it works in ISAC. So it's really important for you to really be aware on what are the risks that's behind. And also in terms of the profitability as well, you can see that we have 12, it's actually majority of the entity that hasn't charges OP taker, have not applied farm to cover IGV costs as well, and also do not actually receive additional fund for IGV. So it means that based on the current financial model, we still very heavily based on EP fee as a way to actually get revenue stream, which is already proved to us that it's not sustainable and we tend to make losses with this kind of financial model. So with that, I want to do an exercise with you. Really fun one. Fun until like you wanted to cry, the kind of fun. So I'm going to give you the link here. And probably, hopefully that you can actually have some realization after this activity. But let me send you the link, okay? So I'm going to share you the what is it called? The spreadsheet. Wait, am I still have you with me? Like, are you still alive?
Yes, Xiaomin.
Wow, thanks. Yes. Thank you everybody. Thank you ASEAN. Okay, and also I'm not sure about where is South Asia and where is East Asia, but I don't think there is East Asia to running GV. Okay, so wait, what is this tab? Oh, I closed the tab already. Okay, so we're gonna do this activity together. This activity will be an interesting reality check. It faces the fear of your life. It's something that you always think about it, but you never do it. Okay, so we will do it in this space. So what we're gonna do is that I compound the whole compliant metrics about what is the thing that you need to fulfill in order to run your GV risk-free. Okay, so with that, you can go to the product. Look at Halima, she's already laughing. She's like, I'm gonna win this game because I know that I fulfill most of my stuff. Let's see, Halima, if you actually fulfill it or not. Okay, so and then look at me, she's already worried because you know that she didn't do anything about it. Okay, so if you actually look at the tab, right? So what you're going to do is that you look at this information and you only tick if it applies to you. So what does it mean? You only tick it if, for example, as my entity, I do not have a contract or contract respecting the contract minimum. If I do not have it, then I will tick, okay, I do not have it. If I, like, for example, I'm not educating my member about APIP, I actually educate my member, then I do not tick it. Not having a clear plan, oh, I actually don't have a clear plan, then I will tick it. Understand? So you only tick to the one that it applies to you. So if the statement is true to you, then you only tick it. Is it clear for everybody? If it clears, can you give me a bit of reaction? Nice. So I'm going to give you some working time, like a 5 minutes for you to go through it. And after that, we can see it. Oh, you cannot access? Nice. Okay, let me... No, everybody can access. How come you cannot access?
The link is wrong, I think. Can you see like the original?
Yes, I can see the original. Now it should be fine, right? Okay, so let's have 5 minutes to work on it and then we can have a bit of discussion. Once you're done, just type in the chat so I will know. Just for you to know is that the more you tick, right, it means that the more high risk that you have, okay? So don't go for like, oh my God, I just want to tick everything and then you're 100%, then you are not, then you are high risk. But also not to lie, okay? Just to, for you to know, it's just a self-assessment.
Turn on me and I get there, you must start.
You only have 30 seconds left around. I'm not your friend. Okay, everybody, if you're done, can you give me a response in the chat? Then I can know how should I move on for that. Hey, IGV Vietnam is, oh, yeah, it's still doing, sorry. Oh, okay, cool. Who what about the rest of you? Oh, wow, I didn't know we have Japan here. Oh my god, hi. I never checked the list. Monica is done, and also India, are you done? When you're filling this matrix, yes. Right? Thank you. I can hear you now. When you're filling this matrix, is it something that actually come to your attention that you didn't know that this is something that you need to fulfill? Like you just realize that, oh my god, there's this thing. Yes, some point. Okay, cool. So I never know. Honestly, yes. Okay, cool. So when you look at the score, right? If you see that you have some percentage of the risk here, it means that these are the percentage of risk that you have. However, the percentage is not accurate because if you actually have a risk on violations 4 and 5, basically you can see different violation will have different consequences. So if you see that you actually have a violation on severity level 5 and level 4 above, you need to be aware is that we will actually do audit and then your entity account will be freeze. So you will not be able to do a change at all because you got freeze until you fix the problem for the severity level 4 and 5. So if you wanted to know more like the sanctions on what are the punishment that will happen, you can go to the first tab. And then you can actually understand is that based on different severity, how many are actually are the thing that you actually do not fulfill, and then what are the consequences if you do not fulfill that. So let's look at GV, right? So for OGV, you can we can see that, for example, not informing stakeholder about AEPP are the one that is actually quite high, and also not having plan B for global host. For this one, it only applies to specific entity they are doing global host. And then the rest, you can see that there are also underlying risks about like not educating a member about APIP. So based on what you all put for both OGV and IGV, right? It's very obvious that our member do not know what is going on with the new APIP. And also stakeholder are not aware about the AEPP. So this is something that is quite common thing that we are miss out right now. And then the rest is like, yeah, not having plan B, not having risk management. So, and also to let you know is that EP travel with the wrong visa, there are some entity that I know that it's quite hard for you to get a proper visa. For example, Malaysia is one of them, right? That's why Malaysia is pick on it. So make sure that you're actually aware on they are using the right visa. In Vietnam IGV, do you have proper visa? Because I remember that you also don't have. Did I call it wrong? What is not having a plan B for global host? If you are same with Malaysia, so you have to have a professional visa that takes longer time to apply. Is that it? Because Malaysia is like that.
Yeah, but it just apply for education. But like traveling or something, we can still use the traveling visa. So I don't know how, like, should I mark that or not?
Oh, okay. So just remember that when you mention about the right visa, right, even though the name can be travel visa or working visa, but under the regulation, if your government already mentioned clearly that you can actually use tourist visa, under that it mentioned about volunteering as one of the category, good to go. So basically the idea is that our name of the visa can be really different according to the context or entity we are in. But if under the regulation and the rules, immigration rules, if we mention about this other visa that you can apply for volunteering and you are actually applying for the right visa, all good. If you are not, at least you need to make sure that you have a proper plan that allow you to do that. So that's a key difference. There's a thing that to take note about the visa part, because I think that AP actually is one of the entity that have issues with visa. I know that Indonesia is pretty safe with the visa. So that's like a good news for you. For mean right, not having a plan B for global host. So there are certain entities are running global host. So if they cannot find global host, they should have a plan B on like what to do next if you cannot find global host. Basically like another backup plan for accommodation, so that there is something that we can make sure that if this doesn't happen, then there is something we can, just a backup plan. Is it clear for mean the cuties, the cutest? Okay. Is it applied for IGB? Yeah. Both. Okay. So if you look at it at here, like I think you can see that like there are a few criteria. Violation is something that we know that is not unattainable in short term, but it needs to be achieved in long term, or at least to make sure that when ICB is doing audit, you have a proof on that. So I think this is something that for you to aware on. So I'm not going to go through each activity. However, I wish that this space would be a space for you to aware that what are the risks that right now you are having, that you that the way you run your operation may actually affecting your organization. So I will tell you a bit more about the sanctions, right? So if you check on the spreadsheet, you can look at my screen right now. If you are opening your spreadsheet, you can look back on the Zoom screen. That you can see that if you are at severity level 5, right? If you have cases that is actually not that's violating, you will lose membership and international level. You will not be able to do any approve or open any new opportunity until the issue is fixed. This apply is that even if GV, you are not doing it properly, it freezes your whole AI account, so your MC account. So even your GT also cannot open opportunity because of that. So just be mindful that like it's something that's quite big, that make sure that you're not affecting the other operation as well. And also we'll have a mandate. ICB maybe will post a mandate globally for you. And also we'll host a physical or virtual audit visit is required. And also, and then all the ICX opportunity that has violation will be suspended. So that's the thing that for you to know about level 5 sanctions. And also for level 4 is similar in terms of no approved, but also you will have a lost case, and then the rest is quite similar. So I think that something that I wanted to address is that the risk of you getting freeze by not having able to do approve or open new opportunity, or your opportunity will be suspend, will be one of the biggest negative impact that will cause to your organizations if you do not actually fulfill the audit. So that's the thing that for you to know. I think you should read more on it so that you can actually be more aware on what is going on with the severity. And of course you can actually get a few severity at the same time. So if you violate a few things with a different severity, then of course you will get different sanctions on it. So with that, I just wanted to know, because we don't have a lot of time, I just want you to share quickly on like what do you think that like for you, because I have a lot of assumption, right? Like I was sharing a lot of assumption that I think maybe because you're busy working with your EWAS stuff, maybe you didn't prioritize it enough. But I wanted to know from your place is that why do you think that, what are the reasons? What are the honest reasons that why you are not reaching 100% GV condition and governance? Based on the checklist that you see that are missing, and also the condition that it is not fulfilled in the tracker just now, what are the things that is missing from you? What stopped you from fulfilling 100%? Yeah, you can share, unmute, or you can type in chat.
I think I can share. Okay, so that is one of the reason why my commission turned into my enemy, because I'm the one who I'm designing my ESD structure, and it support a lot for the operations to my commission. For example, like marketing, attraction, sales, CSP, and it's not support for GV minimum as well. And my commission also doing the normal operation with just some add-in, for example, safety guideline. They know that they have to fulfill the GV minimum. But I never, how to say, cascade anything to them to do it. But me, I choose to be the one who make it all, like who create all of it. and ensure that I can run like 100% of GV minimum. And for my commission, just do it the same, because when it's, I cascade to them, I cannot really make them understand every single detail. For example, for me, I cannot understand what's it, having the plan B for global host or something. Then I don't know how to explain to them. And monthly, we have a commission call from global, but it's not, it's a lot of information. And I just know that I have to do it, but I don't know how to utilize my network to do it. Yeah.
Mm. But regarding like when you do not know certain information, right? Have you checked on the GCP, like, or like the proof from other entity that may actually helps you to find similar information that they are working, that you can actually learn from them?
Yeah, I check it, but maybe that's one of another reason, because when I check, I just feel it's very theoretical. It's not really practical.
Okay.
Yeah. It's kind of, okay, so we have that document and then we fulfill that minimum and what next?
But like right now, just to understand, right, is that because in the end of the day, all these things, whether it's co-create with your network or you do deliver, you do it yourself and you cascade to your network, it has to be done right for the safety and also for the, to avoid any risk. Then how do you plan to move forward from there?
For me, I do the safety guideline, the thing that I feel it practical enough. For example, the safety guideline that I send to the EP, then I feel, okay, so this document will be read by the EP and I feel it practical enough, then I do it myself and I cascade to my commission.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Understand. Thank you, Min, for sharing. Really appreciate it. Anyone else also wanted to share or like type in a chat, it works, whatever. Like whatever approach, it works.
I think I can share. Yeah. 0% progress. I think two main points.
Yeah, tell me. Which,
okay, like two main points, which is like right now, we focus more on AWA ma. Yeah, like the whole network, it focus more on AWA and also the operation and the goal for AWA so big as well. So main, this is our main focus right now. And the second thing will be because I decide already to postpone the operation of OGV to the next summer. That's the reason why we already plan to have the GV minimum in, like we work on in GV minimum in December 1, la, December and January. Yeah, and already have the detailed plan for this. Yeah, and also like right now we are already finished the use survey that we can understand more regarding the insight of our customer, like how they see regarding the OGV volunteer abroad. And also if we are promoting GV right now, do they feel sensitive in this situation? Because I, the COVID-19 is also in Malaysia right now as well. Yeah. So I think it's all from us, but generally have the clear like plan, what's the thing we need to focus on. Yeah.
All right. Thank you, Nina, for sharing. So with that, we don't have a lot of time, but I think I just wanted to like be more direct in the approach that like, why do we actually must do it now? Because I know that a lot of you are having a plan where, okay, because right now my border is closed, that's why I did not prioritize it. I will prioritize it when it's the time, like maybe a few months later, maybe when the COVID situation get better, then only I will start doing it. I know that a lot of you are thinking about it, and also know that like definitely it doesn't make sense to push for doing a change right now or volunteering right now. However, let's put our perspective into like talking about like how can we actually be better educating our members about the condition and governance. How can we make sure that there's a proper system behind all this before another COVID happen again, before our people are actually doing a change? Because the thing is that when we talk about we are doing GV conditions or when we're doing governance, we are actually not asking them to do a change. We are actually telling them on what are the, how your safety will be guaranteed. How can I make sure that if we cancel you, what would be the consequences? It's actually a better communication and better stakeholder management. We are not asking them to do a change right now. It's not going to affect our branding. It's basically reinforcing that we care about their safety, and it's actually helping us to brand ourselves as an organization that take care of the safety. So I think one honest thing that I will tell you is that we cannot afford to handle risk. To be honest with you, if your entity has one case that one person got infected and it spread to other entity, it spread to other organization, that branding actually affects you much worse than any other thing that you can imagine. There will be media showcasing it, or you need to compensate on certain things that Isaac, we will not be able to do it. We don't have a very strong legal team. We don't have a very strong PR team. That if this thing happened, it's gonna, the impact is much more serious. But the easier thing that for us to do is to avoid all these things happen so that we can actually make sure that we can minimize it as much as possible. And also ICB will start their audit in January 2021. Some of you think that, oh, I can do it for the next week because I only have EP next week. But you already have some EP already in the funnel. They are quite lost and they do not know what to do. And then ICB is going to do auditing. Once they start auditing, whatever sanction that is mentioned, it will apply to you. So even though you think that the time, you still have more time, but it's actually not necessarily true. And also, your customer will probably feel really blur, or your partner will feel really blur about what is going on with Isaac because there's no active communication with them so far. So you're going to lose trust from your customer as well. And it's going to affect your branding as well. With that, I think that something to also mention about is that this whole GV financial model as well, that's also part of the governance, should be also being taken care of as well. Because if you want your member to start charging the right amount, if you want to make sure that your member doing Isaac or doing GV in the safety way, it's not something that I can downscale in a month. We all know that how much time it takes to build them. And since we already have this information in the last around February, but until now, we still haven't successfully implemented, then which means that if you, by the time when you can actually do realization, physical realization, then you only, onboard them 2 months before, it's not going to be effective because you know that it takes a long amount of time for our member to get used to things, to get familiar with the information. So I think that's something like a reality check that I want to give it to you as well. And also, if you're not very sure about what are the things to ensure in your change management plan, there is this whole document that actually outlines things that you can actually refer to it as well. And also, you can ask for help globally. So one thing that I really want to share with you is Airbnb, right? Because we know that Airbnb is like the organization that we are very familiar on it. So for Airbnb, there's something called online experience, which is quite interesting that I was filtered for social impact. And it was actually a few things like about animal sanctuary or get to know safari life, or talking about shark, which is something that could be animal rights, or it could be meditation or personal well-being. So these are the kind of Airbnb experience they are having. So because of COVID, right, it's also difficult for Airbnb business as well. So I think this also can apply to us as Isaac. I know that a lot of you has been taking up more responsibility for EWA because you cannot do a change. That's why your MC team are asking you to do more virtual EWA, or you're being part of the team. But it is fine. It is okay. I'm not saying that you should do a change. You should go for a GV, even though it's not safe for you. You should stop GV if it's not safe for you. That's the thing that will make it really clear. So it's okay that you're doing virtual EWA. However, for organization as Airbnb, besides the fact that they are also exploring online experience, they are also providing a hub for their hosts as well to allow them to understand on how they can actually deal with COVID-19. How can we have a better safety standard? What's the thing that we can do to look ahead on that? How can we make sure that our space is actually protecting it? What is the thing that you should be aware on in your rights? If there is a customer cancel the policy, what should you do? So even organization as Airbnb has a proper communication channel or tool, and also there's also working on the safety, then it's not Isaac, it's not us that's crazy, that's demanding you to do both EWA at the same time, making sure that you have condition and governance on place. That is how the world's working right now. COVID, even Airbnb has to cancel certain bookings because there are certain lockdown. Basically there are certain country or territories where the government restrict that. The lockdown, they cannot do any, they cannot book, people will cancel the Airbnb. So it's something that common happen. People cancel our project. People break realization with us. It happens to Airbnb as well. But then the thing is that for them, they still need to make sure that the safety are in place. We are taking care of the standards. We are making sure that people know what is their right, what is their guest right, what is the host right. At the same time, they are also exploring another alternative, which is something like EWA, which is something called online experience. So it's the same assets. But what can we learn from that? Because whatever thing that we're trying to do, it seems like it's really hard, it's really impossible, but it may not be that. Because if other external can do it happen, I believe that we can also at least learn something and we can actually do it a little better than what we are doing right now. So I think that's something that I really want to share with you. In the end, just make sure that you are clear on how can you balance both short and long-term needs. And we don't have time for the working time, but I think that it would be really important for you to actually draw what are the realistic timeline and also what are the activities that you should do to make sure that you can complete the condition and the governance. Because I want to make sure that we actually are able to run GV in the long term. And I know that in Isaac, we stopped talking about GV because we are scared of the risk of GV. But also one of the most beautiful things that has happened in Isaac is also because of the global volunteer, the experience of your member, the experience of your customer, the partner, the stories of the impact of the community. All these things means a lot. And that's what makes us until today. The reason why we are so connected to Isaac is because of global volunteer product as well. And in order to make sure that the GV memory can stay last, I really want to make sure that let's evolve this product together, because you are that generation going to make a huge difference. In the past, even when I was MCP, I wasn't there enough to say, let's stop operation and really work on our legality and our governance. I wasn't brave enough to do that. But right now you have that space and you have that opportunity. And we need to rethink on how we are defining success in GV, because success in GV maybe right now is more about how can we have low risk, more sustainable, rather than just a number of realization or approval. So with that, I just want to recap, which is like, it's a reborn for GV to become a product that can be run in the low risk, profitable and impactful. And maybe you didn't hear it enough, but I really want to thank you for what you are doing, because you are doing one of the really hard job that few generations didn't do. And now you have to be the one who actually fix a lot of things that is happening in the product. Thank you for what you do. Although we don't recognize your number of realization or approval, but it doesn't matter. What matters is that after your generation, your successor can do a better, more powerful, impactful GV with a lower risk and also higher profitability. Let's think about the long-term kind of benefit that we will bring with the current effort that we are doing right now, so that we can build GV to be a stronger product than ever. Then that's when we can say, do we need to bring GV to be the focus of Isaac again or not? So that's all for this session. Thank you so much for your time. I'm so sorry for the delay. I hope that you get some perspective. And right now, I think it's a space for you to actually go to another, back to the old link. Do you know that the link that you were in just now? So you should go back to the old link so that there will be some way forward and some conclusion on that. Yeah, thank you so much. And I will see you later. Yes. Bye, everybody. Oh, we have Natalie Chan. Okay, bye-bye. Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.